Hi everyone, this is GKCS. Today we are going to be talking about a roadmap for placements. Let us take your journey from your first year. For a first year student, there's a mixed syllabus in most colleges. In fact, if you see, the syllabus includes physics and mathematics. So it may or may not be very relevant to you. However, there is one subject that you should really, really focus on as a computer science student, and that is programming. Now, programming does not mean necessarily that you need to be a champion at C++ or Java. You won't be anywhere in 1 year, but you really need to know what programming means. It means that you're taking a set of instructions and sending it to a computer and getting the desired response. So there is some math involved here, and there is some language involved here. The power of the language in a program is going to help you talk to the computer the way you want it to behave. If you want the computer to compute 3 plus 3, it's just a plus operator. But if you want to compute 3 plus some number, and then you go inside and it does 3 plus some number, that's recursion. So the basics of programming are super important to know. Okay, you won't learn recursion in any other place. So that's the reason why I'm mentioning programming as super important in first year. There's something else also that you can do, and that is look at data structures. In your first year, you're probably going to be dealing with very simple data structures. One of them is arrays. The other one is linked list. And there is stack. And there is queue. Okay, don't worry if it is not in your college syllabus. If they expect you to just know about arrays and, you know, they expect you to know about very simple things, just simple programming, it's okay. But it's not okay for you, in the sense that you are capable, like your brain has developed enough at that point to be able to understand what are arrays, what are linked lists, what are stacks, and what are queues. So I would suggest in your first year, especially if you're a CS student, to over prepare a little bit and go for these data structures, which really help you understand the basics of programming. Okay, some of these data structures are used inside a computer. In fact, all of them are. So it's good to know. They're very practical also. It won't waste your time. First year is going to be pretty tough. You're going to find it probably difficult to pass the exams because you have such a varied syllabus. But in your second year, you go for specialization, where things get tougher but also more fun. At this point, your basics will really help you boost to the next level. And what you should focus on here is data structures, operating systems, networks, and databases. Extremely important subjects: data structures, operating systems, networks, and databases. What about the other, you know, languages? What about theory of computer science? Oh, that's not so useful. Only a stupid person would say that. Theory of computer science is very, very important. And there are other subjects also, like you might have data warehouse in some place. You might have soft computing. It's important. It's useful. But if you're talking about strictly in terms of placements, if you're looking at the roadmap for placements, then these subjects are critical. Those are important. These are critical. Okay, and many of these subjects, like all four of these, form the foundation for any kind of computer application that you have. So even in terms of soft computing, you'll see some concepts from this come up there. You'll probably have some data structures concepts over there. If you're looking at mobile computing, let's say, then networks is sometimes it seeps into that subject. Okay, so this is going to form the base of your computer science fundamentals, and you'll see that this becomes super important later on. When you're actually going for placements. Okay, in your second year, what else can you do? Now, this is a place, because you're specializing, you can go for two paths which are a little distinct, and I'll talk about it. There's a lot of memes and funny stuff that is called, which is development, and the other one, which is competitive programming. Now, it's a pity that we talk about it this way, because competitive programming and development are two paths which are looked at in terms of placement. But truly, what would be really interesting is if you had an interest in algorithms and data structures and really solving complex mathematical problems using programming, competitive programming would come naturally to you. This is where I would go, likely. And because you're a computer science engineer, which means that along with the scientist, there's also the mechanic inside you, you need to know how to develop systems also. You can't just talk about the mathematical component of systems, you have to actually do the wiring also. Okay, So development means that you can code, you can code well. This does not mean efficiency. It means that you can code in a way that other people can read it and the code is correct. So here, if you see in terms of development, the highest flag is for readability. Other people can read my code and understand what I'm trying to do. It's good. And then the second one is correctness. And this one, number one would be correctness. And the second one would be efficiency. Now don't go around saying that, you know, oh my God, efficiency also matters in the real world. It does, but it would be at point number three. Starting off, you don't really care whether your code is readable or not here. It runs once and it's gone. It's gone forever. While here, you really care about your code being readable because it continuously adapts to new requirements. One thing that I would strongly suggest you to do is to ace your practicals. A lot of students don't look at this, but you build a lot of good reputation if you're the fastest person in your practicals. Okay, with your teachers and with yourself. Many of these things form the bedrock of what happens later. So later comes third year. I'll just note that down over here. Applying for an internship will really, really help you boost your chances for placement. There's nothing like an internship to boost your chances for placements. Open source programs, projects, whether you have personal projects or college projects. And apart from that, you have contests or hackathons. Note that in competitive programming, you have competitive programming contests where you can shine. It is a difficult place to shine because there's a lot of competition right now. And the other thing is, this is just a set of contests where you can, you know, stand out. While in hackathons, projects, open source contributions and internships, these tend to be a little more related to the job that you'll be doing. So when it comes to a smaller, medium-sized company, even startups, they care a little more about this. When it comes to large companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft, they tend to care more about your, let's say, learnability or IQ. So the IQ tests that they take are a little more geared towards algorithms, while the rest of the folks are a little more geared on how much you can do right now. Demonstrable skills. IQ. Okay. Having said that, you might have an inclination towards one of these things. So I'll tell you exactly what each one of them does. An internship is going to be in a company. So you have to apply with a resume. You look at the things that you have done. So that would be projects that you have worked on in college, any kind of contests and its results, and so on. So a good pattern for this is called the star pattern, which means what was the situation, that is S. T is task, so what was the task? What was the action that I took, or what were the actions that I took? What were the things that I did? Task is basically these things needed to be done. And this is what I actually ended up doing. They're slightly different. Okay, you may not choose to do certain things, or when you did something, you realize that, oh, the task was something else, but I ended up doing something else. And the last one is result. Star is a structured way to tell you what you did in your resume. And the basic idea with an example will be you are trying to create an image processing app to find criminals, okay, with CCTV footage or CCTV images. Now, that is the situation. What was the task? I had to use some libraries to find out which criminal is matching with which person. What is the action? I used Python and these kind of libraries to actually get the thing done. What was the result? What is the accuracy over there? Did I speed up the algorithm? What exactly happened? What is the result? So in this way, your resume, when you read through points, it becomes much more easy. It's structured also. The most important things are ticked off. What about open source projects? Now, someone who's spoken about this in length is Kunal Kushwaha. I would suggest you go through his channel about what are some good open source projects to contribute to, especially as a beginner. Then comes projects. In projects, you can have your own projects, personal projects. Let's say you create an app so that you can split expenses. Okay, so that might be your own personal project. It could be college projects where you team up with a professor, you make a small team of two or three people, and then you work on something. That is also useful. And then you have hackathons and contests. These are short-term things. They show how good you are during a contest. And in a short period of time, compared to thousands of other people, what was your rank? So here I'm mostly interested when it comes to result, the rank. Here I'm interested in what happened, how many people saw it, how many people used it, what did you exactly do, what was the result over here. Open source, I'm interested in whether you were able to contribute at all or not, and how many people use this open source project, that would be the situation. And in the internship, most of the things are taken care of already, so you can just mention the things that you did in your internship here in your resume. In terms of weightage, internships are the most important. Open source contributions are also rare, but quite important. It's useful. Projects are important. And hackathons and contests are useful. Okay, all of them are good, but this is probably the best. When it comes to hackathons or contests, they do show your development skills. They do show your intelligence quotient. But if you're trying to showcase your achievements, participation is not really an achievement. So if you want to mention it only if you have nothing else to mention, right? So that's your third year. In third year, of course, you'll also be going through a lot of your subjects, and it's best to pay some attention to the subjects that you have, which have been designed, the syllabus has been designed in a way which is extremely useful to you. Don't just worry about your placements. You have a long career and a long life. The placement will happen. If you do things which you like, they tend to give back to you. Okay, they build a strong bedrock, and I'm speaking with experience here. I have like 10 years since I've graduated. I can tell you some of the things that you learn here and some of the habits that you build here will really stick with you for a while, 10 years at least. All right, so we come to the final year. I'm writing down here and in red because I think this is the bottom line. The final year is a little bit hectic for some people because they are totally focused on placements or an MBA program or, you know, masters. But specifically, if you're going for placements, then these are the things you need to focus on. You need to apply to companies. Now, you might think that I don't really need to do this. I have a set of companies coming to my college. But it's better to apply to companies which are outside also, because if you go to buy anything in the market, you also want to have some competition so that the price comes down. In this case, you are the seller. So you want multiple markets. So applying to companies can help you not just bargain better, you might actually find a place which is better for you, and they're not coming to your campus. So apply to many companies, maybe 50 companies, 100 companies, depends on you. In the US, this is a big thing. They just send their resume to hundreds of companies. Okay. The second thing will be, at the same time, practice. This is specific to interview preparation. So we are talking about data structures and algorithms. Okay, it doesn't matter whether you're amazing at development. Some of the companies expect you to know about data structures and algorithms. That is something that you have to do. Lead code is quite useful when you're doing any kind of DSA preparation. You could also use corporate programming websites like Codeforces, HackerRank, HackerEarth to prepare for your data structures and algorithms. If you have a internship already, a pre-placement offer is something that you want to target. Again, it's important to have an offer beforehand, and you might really love this, you might be super happy with it, but still apply to other companies. That's something that, you know, you can do. If you're very happy with it, yeah, just stay in a good frame of mind and start studying the things that will really make you good on the job. That's also something you can do. Get out of the placement race. And finally, you are going to be actually sitting for the interviews. There are a few interview tips. I have already shortlisted them in the YouTube videos I've made. Maybe another thing that you can do is look at some system design on the low level side. So low level design. This is a recent development in a lot of companies which come for placements. What they have, I think, realized is that the IQ factor is quite important, but it's not the only factor which should be tested. They should also test for development. But how do you test for development in such a short span of time? So people can, you know, show their projects and show the things that they've done in the past couple of years or 3 years. But then people lie on the resume. Okay, there's a lot of fake projects which go around. So you can't really trust them. So what ends up happening is they ask you either a take-home assignment or a low-level design question, or they can ask you to build something right then and there in front of them, which is almost like a low-level design question. Okay, you might be building a small website or something. So this is asked sometimes. This is quite critical if you're sitting for a large company. If it's a small company, they may not even ask you DSA. But definitely something that you want to do is apply to companies, and that is going to be done using your resume. And that's it. That's how simple placements are. You know, in your first year, focus on your programming skills. In your second year, focus on data structures, operating systems, networks, databases. Important to note, I'm not saying let go of everything else. Trust me, after you get placed, you're going to realize, oh, well, the other guy knows really well about soft computing. I don't. So all I did was prepare for placements. Those guys are actually smart and they deserve to be here. Okay. It might be one of the things which come through you. Imposter syndrome is a thing if you're over prepared for clearing the test instead of actually working in the company. So yeah, second year, then you choose not just a path. You can always come back. This is sometimes you switch back. This is a very narrow path. Unfortunately, this is a much wider path. You can go for a UI engineer role. You can go for a backend engineer role. You can go for a DevOps engineer role also. This is more generic and a little more engineer based. This is more on the science side of things. And finally, in your third year, try to secure a placement of internship. If that's not the case, then you go for open source projects. If that doesn't work out, apply to all the companies that you know. Practice your DSA and your low-level design skills. You'll be fine. Things will go well. You're going to get placed. Okay. So I believe that this is a comprehensive roadmap when it comes to preparing for placements throughout your college duration. If you have any doubts or suggestions on this roadmap, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. Until next time, see you.